And this evening we are very revved up and excited as we're about to begin our sixth Woven Destiny concert. We're sitting under this incredible sukkah. We've just had our bite, compulsory bit of food under the sukkah, and we're ready to start. But I think just before we start, my friends, it's important to let you know that we are going to remove our masks. We're adhering to COVID guys, you can remove your mask because we're outside, obviously. And then later on indoors, we'll deal with the same thing with the appropriate distancing, etc., in order to make sure that we maintain the very important COVID principles and ideas and protocols. So, also to explain to you that this is the first time that this has been done in such a way. We used to, in the past six times that we've done this, we used to doing this on an open stage with a live audience and going through with our energy and passion. And this time, for the benefit of you and you, yes, and even you sitting at home, we're actually putting the whole thing down on film. The whole thing is going on video. And you might be in Australia watching this, and you might be in Canada, and you might be in Gauteng, or you might be right here in Cape Town, and you've just watched the incredible drone footage of where we are. So please excuse us if there's one or two little continuity glitches and so on and so forth, a new direction that we're busy exploring, but certainly worth the ability of being able to reach so many thousands of people. So before I talk myself to a standstill, I'd like to introduce to you to my partner in crime, the founder and originator of the concept of the Woven Destiny concert, Liz, over to you.
Thank you, Erez, my partner in business. Wow, all I can say is I just want to thank everybody out there that has made this virtual concert possible. But firstly, on camera, I want to thank my darling husband who has put up with me for all these weeks and months preparing for this. And then to thank Tamar and your incredible team. Tamar Lazarus is the past president of WIZO South Africa. Together with Shelley Friedman, who is the present president of South Africa, and all those amazing, I call them the wonderful whiz kids of WIZO, the ladies that pull this cart up the hill. And as a cheer lady of one of very few Christian branches of WIZO, I'm very proud to be able to raise money and support Israel in this way via WIZO. What an honor. And now I'd like to really introduce you to my precious friend and collaborator in raising money for Israel through WIZO, Tamar Lazarus. And what a friend, what a woman, and her ladies to work with. And Tamar, I just would love you to share a little bit about WIZO and where this money is going to go for those who don't understand this incredible world global women, Jewish women's organization. Thank you, Tamar.
Toda rabba, Elizabeth, and thank you and Jamie and Erez for the most amazing concerts that you beheld. And the reputation is following you, and we love taking part and be partnered with you. And yes, the money that is raised tonight from this concert will go to WIZO projects in Israel. The projects from daycare centers, school, youth villages, shelters for women, all to educate, uplift, empower women and children in Israel and create a better society and a better Israel for all. So thank you for supporting us, and how we later on will put the banking details for those that haven't donated yet, and if you would like to do in the future. So from all of us at WIZO in South Africa and around the world, we want to thank you from the bottom of our heart to our many Christian and Jewish friends that supported and sponsored tonight, and carry on blessing Israel and being the great friends and the guardians on the wall for Israel. So we'll wish you Shana Tova, Chag Sameach, Shalom, and Toda Rabba.
Sure. Thank you, Tamar. It's just, we really want to come and again to say thank you to all those incredibly generous sponsors that have made this concert possible. It's very unique. It's going to be a great experience, and we just want to say to you, enjoy it with us. It's been worth every bit of effort. It's been an absolutely amazing time. So I just want to say to my friends and our colleagues, you know, guys, what are we waiting for?
What are we doing here?
What are we doing here? Let's go inside and let's have a wow. Let's go and do it.
Let's make it happen.
Let's enjoy it. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Let's get up and go, on our way.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
do come true. Someday I wish upon a star.
Yes, out of this world, amazing. Absolutely unbelievable. Well, I've got a little surprise for you.
What?
Because we've managed to grab them from the back of the stage, the two superstars of the previous act, Daniel and Clara. Come here. Come here, guys.
Wow.
Come stand by here. Tell me something. Who taught you how to play the bell so beautifully?
My mom.
Was it your mom?
Yes.
She's very good. Hey? She should be very, very proud of you. Is she proud of you, do you think?
Yes.
Yeah? Give them a huge round of applause. Aren't they absolutely amazing? Well done, guys. Thank you very much. Bye. See you later. And Monica, you have absolutely every right to be incredibly proud. That is tremendously beautiful, beautiful work. So next, friends, we have a collection of people from all over the country who come together to make incredible music for you. They are the band that we are super dependent and reliant on. They mix their music in such energy and such vigor and such style with a mix of traditional and cosmopolitan style in a way that only they know how and only they can perfect. a huge thank you and a big round of applause for the incredible ZAMAR.
Wow, isn't that absolutely amazing? And you got me tapping my feet and I don't know whether to clap first or tap first or absolutely amazing. Guys, it's absolutely, wasn't it phenomenal? What, can you hear some applause from that? Yeah, absolutely incredible.
Thank you.
Yes, that's a lot better. Fantastic. Well, I want to introduce you to Veronica. And Veronica, maybe you can tell us a little bit more about your phenomenal band and about your music and about the heart of where this music comes from.
Yeah, thank you, Erez. Well, at first I want to say we're from Stellenbosch, but now I'm a little bit out of breath. I don't know how Monica's fingers keep that, you know, playing the accordion at that tempo, but keeping in mind that she has two busy children, that must probably keep her quite fit. As you know, Zamar is a Hebrew word, Erez, and it actually directly translates, it says he sings. And that's exactly what we do through our instruments. We love making music and singing songs through our instruments, all being here together. In plain Afrikaans, we say, ons sommer dis sommer lekker. And for those of you who didn't understand, you'll know. In Afrikaans, it means what we sound like. Anyway, we enjoy making our music. And thank you that we can be part of this concert. It's such a privilege. Elizabeth and Erez, that Zamar can be on the stage.
Isn't that something? I just sense the energy growing and growing and growing. And once again, an incredible round of applause to Veronica, to the entire team on the stage, to the wonderful little kids. Give them all a big round of applause one more time, everybody. I want to hear it all the way from your homes. Come on.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, this bumble boogie just reminded me of how hectic life can become. Really running around after all our obligations and just longing for a moment where you could sit down and relax and just become quiet a little bit. We tend to be so overwhelmed by life. And yet in this next song, it speaks about this place that we all long for. Somewhere there is a place for us to be quiet and to rest. I'm going to welcome on stage with us Lyudmyla Rukavitsyna-Heath and Kevin Isaacs. And then we have a beautiful surprise during the song. We have actually the privilege of having a guest artist singing all the way from Jerusalem with us, Mr. Barry Braun. But ladies and gentlemen, let's not keep you longer for this beautiful surprise. Welcome on stage with me, Lyudmyla and Kevin.
Together with time to spare, time. for us. Somewhere a time for us. Time together with time to spare. Time to learn. Time to care. Somehow, someday.
That song just takes me someplace.
It's unbelievable.
And to my heart, that is Jerusalem. I don't know if you think sure. that too.
Sure.
Yeah. And there's a painting just behind Erez, and it's a painting that I did that hangs very proudly now in the Rebecca Seif Center just outside Jerusalem. And to me, Jerusalem is the epicenter of everything. It always has been and always will be. So as I mentioned outside earlier, that I have the privilege of sharing tonight the three pilgrim festivals. And you know, my goodness.
Just before you start, if I can disturb you for a second and add a little bit. I remember when Barry called me from Israel, and I think he made the call to you as well. And he was just saying, well, I'll just pop over to Jerusalem.
Yeah.
To see where would be the right place to. And as he just said, I'll just pop over to Jerusalem.
Yeah.
I think I started crying. I started realizing that, you know, you don't really realize the privilege. What a privilege that is, that you can say, I'll just pop over to Jerusalem and see what's going on, see what I can do my song.
I know.
It was very touching, wasn't it?
Hey, yeah. One day we will all be there, God willing. Anyway, as you all know, besides just explaining the three chagim, the pilgrim festivals, I'm also going to share how this is a blueprint that is galvanized not only in the Chagim, but in the days of creation and also in the commandments. So bear with me as I try and crunch this all in to a few minutes during this concert, that I know that all the music that we've chosen actually is in line with this blueprint. So let's look at this beautiful menorah. I mean, we know that this is the symbol of Israel. And this is the blueprint. This is the key that unlocks everything for life. And the first chagim that God gave to the Israelites, the Jews, was Passover, right? And he said to remember it forever. It was the exodus out of slavery. And not only to remember it, but to celebrate it on a very specific day, the 14th day of the first month of his calendar. So we know that this was this grand exit. And the interesting thing, Erez, was that there was a multitude of people that left with the Jews.
Sure.
They were saying, I'm out of here too. And they decided to follow the Israelites come what may. So how does that relate to the days of creation? Well, what did God do on the first day? He separated light from dark. Do the maths. What is the first commandment? That we shall serve no other God but him. So on a personal level, we all have to have an exodus out of our bondages,
sure.
out of our degradation. It's a choice. And be the light in a dark world and follow one God, and that is the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And on that cue, I'm going to call upon you to sing Exodus, that beautiful theme song of that epic movie. So please, my brother.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This land is mine. God gave this land to me. This brave and ancient land to me. And when the morning sun reveals her heels and pleas. Then I see a land where children can run free. So take my hand and walk this land with me, and walk this holy land with me. Though I am just a man, when you are by my side, with the help of God, I know I can be strong. Though I am just a man, when you are by my side, with the help of God, I know I can be strong to make this land my home. If I'm as fired, I'll keep this land my home. Until I die, this land is
Yerushalayim shel zahav Sing hallel to you. With pretty rhymes I shall not crown you, as other poets do. Upon my lips there burns forever your name so dear, so old. Imeshkachech Yerushalayim, aglow with light and gold. Yerushalayim shazahah v'shel nechoshet v'shel v'shelah, alo lechol shirayim ani kinor. Yerushalayim shazahah v'shel nechoshet
Well, thank you, Aviva, for that incredible song, Jerusalem of Gold, Yerushalayim Shel Zahav. You know, Liz, that Yerushalayim Shel Zahav, to my mind, and many people don't know, it's, to me, it's the ultimate love song ever written.
Yes.
And what makes it so much the ultimate love song is that it's not from a woman to a man, or a man to a woman even.
Hmm.
It's from a people to a city.
Wow.
And it's got such a beautiful history. It was written by Naomi Shemer, who was one of Israel's greatest songstresses, ladies of song. She was amazing. And the first part she wrote before Jerusalem was recaptured and retaken.
Wow.
So there were some very sad verses in the song.
Yeah.
And then she had the privilege of being commissioned to rewrite the song after Jerusalem was taken.
Wow.
So a great credit to Aviva for having done the song so incredibly well. A lady of song. And Aviva, your hearing you, I mean, I'm sure that everybody in Cape Town knows you as a great lady of opera that you are, and it's absolutely a pleasure having you with us and having you bring in this song of Yerushalayim Shel Zahav to us this evening. So the next incredible surprise that we have all the way from Eretz Israel is a gentleman by the name of Omer Eshel. And Omer, Liz, I think you described him as a man of a bundle of energy. Is that correct?
Absolutely. A firebrand.
A fireball. Okay, so we're very privileged to have Omer shooting at us and with us and together as part of this project all the way from Israel. And he'll give you a few of his words in just a second. I just need to introduce him. You know, he's a fourth generation Israeli. So that goes back almost to biblical times, you know. That's a little while. He was a consul of tourism for Israel way back, and also ran the Ulpanim for all the kibbutzim for a period of time. And for those that don't know, the Ulpan is where people are actually taught to speak Hebrew.
Awesome.
So that's quite a big portfolio that he had. Mm-hmm. He is also a very, very highly qualified tour guide. Really the depth of Israel from a Judaic and a Christian point of view.
Yes.
Is a bundle of energy. So let's not waste any more time and let's hand you over directly to Omer so he can give you some of the feedback and bring us into the picture of Israel right now.
Thank you, Erez and Liz. Thank you so much for letting me be a part of this wonderful Woven Destiny concert. It's such a fitting name, such a fitting name. And I'll tell you why. I was thinking what will be the best place for us to discuss about this idea of woven destinies between Jews and non-Jews as followers of God. And I thought that the best place to do it will be here in my backyard, overlooking the Sea of Galilee behind me. So my home is situated on a place which in Hebrew called Sukkot Haon, and in English will be the Cliffs of Gadara. Very, very biblical place. And what's amazing about this place is that behind me, The Sea of Galilee is cradle of Christianity, as you see right there. And just above that, you'll see Mount Tabor and the Lower Galilee. And in Mount Tabor, in the book of Judges, we have the battle of Deborah and Barak, son of Avinoam, versus Sisera. And this is the cradle of the kingdom of Israel. So in the same place, we see this woven destiny of the two faiths. And I want also to address the fact that as we see rise of anti-Semitism in the world, we need to understand there is something that is called the Jewish canary. The same as in the past, miners used to put canaries in mines, and once the canary was affected, they knew they need to evacuate because of the gas. Same thing. Every time that the Jews were suffered, the rest of humanity suffered. Just check throughout history. And that is why we need to stand together and we need to fight against anti-Semitism and to understand that today it's with the Jews, tomorrow is going to be at your doorstep. And I want to remind also to our friends that in Israel, the Bible comes to life, and you can see and learn about us. Just check us on Facebook, YouTube, Google, the Bible come to life. Thank you so much for having me on the show. God bless and shalom from the cliffs of Gadara.
Right, so next up on the piano, holding the stage all by himself, and I think you'll see that he can certainly do it, is an incredible young man, a bit of a musical savant. I think, well, the apple doesn't fall too far from the tree. His name is Christian Bell, and he's the son of the fantastic Veronica Bell that has thrilled us with her band right through the show. And Christian is going to play for us this evening, Fantasy Impromptu by Chopin. We're looking forward to it, Christian. Away over to you.
I think we've got a maestro on our hands.
Sure. Incredible.
Wow, Christian, thank you, my darling, for having come and shared this talent. It just blows one away. And now I have the privilege of crunching into these few minutes the next incredible Mo'edim feast of our God. It is the, if you look again to the blueprint, the menorah, it is actually the second pilgrim festival, but it is the fourth branch. And if you see this menorah, it is actually the stem of the whole menorah. And God, the original menorah, God commanded that they were to beat it out of a solid lump of gold. And as you see, the other branches are stemming from that. So what could be this weighty that God has chosen the stem of his blueprint, of his menorah, to teach us something? And when you think of what he gave his people on this day, and it's called Shavuot, which in Hebrew is Feast of Weeks, 7 whole weeks after Passover, they were to count, and he gave no other than the law on Mount Sinai, the most critical intervention of God to his people, his laws and his statutes and his commands that just showed his heart for his people to live right.
Sure.
So how could this relate to the days of creation? Oh, and it also said in the Torah that it is easier for the sun and the moon and the stars to be obliterated than it is for one jot or tittle of that law to drop away.
Wow.
So he is committed to his word and what he has promised his people, Israel. That is how galvanized this law is. Mm. So how does that relate to the days of creation? What did God come and create on this day? If you read Torah, he flung the sun and the stars and the moon into the cosmos to mark time. Days, nights by the sun and the moon, and seasons and Sabbaths. They were to mark time. And it is priceless because he has given us a way to walk. Holech, isn't that the way?
Exactly, yeah.
And so then how does this relate to the commandments? No other than the fourth commandment is that we are to remember his Sabbath and keep it holy. Erez, this is the watershed that has divided and separated the Israelites, the Jewish people, from the rest of the nations. Are these Mo'edim and his Sabbaths and his feasts. They are galvanized into the cosmos. They are eternal,
sure,
forever and ever. Even when Mashiach comes, we will be carrying on with this blueprint.
Sure.
It is mind-boggling. And it has also been what has caused so much persecution, because the world hates anything to do with God and his people and his land. Why the trouble in Israel? Why the anti-Semitism? It's because you guys that we want to come and align ourselves with are the ones that are carrying the salvation for the world. You are carrying the blueprint as a nation and a people. And that's why, for the listener out there who aren't Jewish, we are going to have to make a very, very serious choice down the line of what God are we serving? The God of these feasts or pagan traditions of man? And it's serious. And it's a watershed that's going to happen down the line, because God's people, like Ruth in the Bible, your people are my people. This little Moabite test said, I am not leaving you.
Sure.
Where you go, we will go. Your God is our God. And this is serious, guys, because we need to make a choice. And that is your decision. And this is the heart of God. When you think of Leviticus, where God gave the instructions to the Jews of when to worship him, how to worship him, and why. This is the Abba we serve. This is the God we serve that wants us with him. and be with him and know him. And these feasts keep us sanctified and close to him. This is the heart of our God, your God, that you've shared with the world. And this, I want to introduce everybody to Mia Carla. She is a beautiful friend of ours from Cape Town. And together with you, they're going to sing a song that is going to bring a tear to every person watching here tonight. Thank you.
Thank you so much. How wonderful to be surrounded by this amazing band. What a privilege and an honor to be involved in this concert. I am of the desert. I'm also of the Khoi people of the desert because my father, his father and his family are from Saudi. And so that is part of my heritage. The Khoi people as well, the first people on the land. And an honor and a privilege to stand and be counted as one of those that have found the true God, the God of the Jews, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the one who, what he says he will do. And I, very quickly before we sing the song, I've got a lion that has been in France many years ago who had been in a French circus. They had broken his jaw, and he's got the skew jaw. And he, when I first encountered him, they described him as the lion who hides, and I never saw him that day, but my heart was instantly connected to him. Anyway, long story short, I wanted to get to know this lion, and I wanted him to know that there's a different side to humans. And so what I decided to do is visit him. And, you know, I always set myself up for rejection because he wouldn't come out. I decided then to go and eat with him, because when you eat with someone, you connect with them. And after almost 3 years now, I've been periodically visiting this lion, and now he recognizes me. And he doesn't always come out. He's, you know, he's a cat. Always expect the unexpected from a cat. But he comes and he sits at the fence with me, and he's roared a couple of times in my face. We're obviously between electric fencing and all of that. But this has taken time and effort. And the scriptures say that if you search for me with your whole heart, you will find me. And for me, that is how I've moved from Hashem to Abba. He's still Hashem. He's still this amazing true God. But we've moved into intimacy and vulnerability when we connect like that. And so I encourage you. I encourage you to go to that place. If the scripture says, if you search for me, like I searched for this lion's heart. I would like wanted his heart. I wanted his heart to get out of the cage. Even though he wasn't in a circus cage anymore, his heart was in a cage. And slowly that started unraveling and he had come out. And so Abba, to call him that is such a beautiful, beautiful name. It's such a homely name. You know, going to sit on your father's lap, put your head against his chest and feel his heartbeat for you. So I encourage the Khoi people to go on this path, to behold, and also you want to get close to Abba, then recognize the apple of his eye, Israel, and you will move his heart. Because I've come to know the deep sorrow, the deep joy that Abba experiences through me finding out his character in the scripture and then also experiencing that. Amazing. So I want to do a song that's done by Avraham Friedman, and I have the pleasure of doing that with Erez. So I would like to invite him to the stage with me. Wonderful to share a stage with you and these amazing musicians. Thank you so much. Abba.
Abba shel kulam.
שלי הוא מלך העולם אבא 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 מלך העולם מלך 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 אבא של שוב ושוב אתה זולח רק אליך עוד בורח אבא אבא של כולם שוב ושוב אתה סולח רק אליך עוד בורח אבא שומר עלינו הוא אוהב אותנו הוא אבא של כולם
במלחמות שומר עלינו בנסתרות גם שם איתנו אבא שלי הוא מלך העולם
Beautiful part about all of this, my friends, is that I think by now that person and that person and that person over there, can you see them? I think they know the words, at least of the chorus. So I think it would be nice if we can get them to sing with us. Okay? Should we try this? Just the chorus? Okay, let's go here. Let's go. Come on.
Abba, 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 Melech HaOlam.
Let's hear you.
Melech, Melech. Melech, Abba Shel Kulam Shuv Veshuv Ata Soleach Rak Elecha Od Boreach Abba
Wanna hear you, come on!
Abba, Abba, Abba Melech HaOlam
Melech HaOlam
Melech, Melech, Melech Abba Shel Kulam Shuv Veshuv Ata Soleach Lecha עוד לא מהחמה
Well, I think I heard them singing. If it wasn't for COVID and needing to stay away, I'd give you a big hug right now because you've moved me to tears. Can we have one more huge round of applause for the incredible Mia Kala with a beautiful song, Abba? Wow! Woo! Always a pleasure to sing with you, Mia Kala. Thank you very much. So what an amazing connection it is that we sing of Abba. And Abba was, I think that was one of the first words that I said when I was a baby, when I was born, you know. All the mothers say, Imma, Imma, but it's somehow easier to say Abba. So I said Abba was one of the first words, and an amazing connection because it's now become an international super connector. Yeah. I mean, people talk of super spreaders, we'll leave that out of the way. We talk about super connectors now, right? Yeah. What are your feelings about the super connector of Abba?
I mean, we've experienced it tonight, you know. It's not as if we, just the way we work together, bringing our music together, bringing our hearts together. I don't see people argue when we make music together, when we sing together. And that's what we've experienced tonight, the power of music, communicating the true love.
You know, it's amazing when you say you don't see people argue. Somehow when you're making music, and people do question, they always question about how to make it maybe that little bit better and how to make it stronger, but nobody is ever arguing anything down. So
tonight we're just looking at the hearts. And I'm so excited while we played this song, I started picturing this next song we're going to play to you at ZAMAR. It's called Song of Celebration, and it's painting this picture of this festival that's busy actually being prepared for each one of us. And it makes me think of Sukkot. This Feast of Tabernacles. Nah, I've got it right there. And so the song starts as if you hear the music and over the hill, and it draws you closer, and you arrive in this town. And for me, God says it's the city of gold, you know. So obviously, we'll picture Jerusalem, with the streets of gold, and where people are dancing, and there's tears, but not for pain and sorrow, but for joy, true joy and laughter. And that is the hope that we have, is that there is a feast that we can look forward to.
I'm looking forward to that big feast.
Yes.
Maybe it started tonight. You never can tell. Hey?
You know, Erez, maybe it's starting tonight. And there's this moment in the song that it sounds like the violin is whispering, whistling actually, but it's a soft whisper of invitation. For those people tonight sitting in your own home and you have a longing to belong, it's an invitation to say you're welcome. Come join us in this festival. So can we play this to you?
Yes, and I'll make space.
Grab your seat so that
I'll make space once again for the incredible ZAMAR. So once again, my friends, put your hands together for them and give them a big, big power welcome as we continue this evening's incredible show.
Thank you.
Well, friends, that was absolutely amazing, and we are now blessed to have with us a superstar of international standards, done work all around the world, and we're really privileged to have him with us this evening, singing specifically for you, and of course for all our viewers and team here as well, a beautiful song, If I Forget Thee, Jerusalem, Im Eshkachech Yerushalayim. I'd like you, even at home, to put your hands together. Huge round of applause and a lot of energy for the one and only Mr. Choni G.
It's my privilege to join you guys this evening. Great to be here. I'm going to be singing, as Erez said, Im Eshkachech Yerushalayim, If I Forget You, Jerusalem. Words that King David prophesied long before the destruction, long before the temple was even built, about the destruction of the temple in Jerusalem. And we pray every day towards Jerusalem, and we pray for its rebuilding and the redemption at the highest joys. You know, at a wedding, we break a glass and we say these words, Im Eshkachech Yerushalayim. We pray for that era of peace and redemption of Mashiach, and when the oneness of God will be revealed. So this is Im Eshkachech. Tidbak l'shani ulechiki im lo eskerechi im lo yahale im lo yahale et Yerushalayim ahalo Return with no delay, picking up the bounty and the spoils on our way. We've been traveling from state to state, and they don't understand what we say. 3,000 years with no place to be, and they want us to give up our milk and honey. Don't you see? Not about the land or the sea, not the country, but the dwelling of His Majesty. Rebuild the temple and a crown of glory. Years gone by, about 60. We were burned in the oven in a century, and a gas tried to choke, but it couldn't choke me. I will not lie down, I will not fall asleep. Yeah, they come overseas and they're trying to be free. Erase the demons out of your memory. Change your name and your identity. Afraid of the past and our dark history. Why is everybody always chasing me? Cut off the roots from your family tree. Don't you see? That's not the way to be free. Jerusalem, if I forget you, fire not gonna come from my tongue. Jerusalem, if I forget you, Jerusalem, if I forget you, fire not gonna come from my tongue. Jerusalem, if I forget you, yeah. Yeah, the love. Better. gdola. Thank you very much.
Wow, Choni, thank you. That song, If I Forget Jerusalem, means something very personal to me. It comes from Psalm 137, where God says, if we do forget her, may our tongue cleave to the roof of our mouth and our hands forget its skill. On that note, I have the privilege now to explain to you the third Pilgrim Festival, which is the last on the menorah branch, the seventh one. And this is called the Feast of Sukkot, which we are celebrating here tonight. And in English, Feast of Tabernacles. It's a feast of utter joy. As I heard Choni singing, it's a time of peace, a millennial of peace when Mashiach comes. And it is wonderful because it's the only feast that Israel actually invites the nations to come and celebrate with her. And on that note, I want to ask the Jewish folk to forgive South Africa for what our nation has done to you over the past. And our biggest prayer is that it will change and that this evening and this blessing towards Israel will somehow open a portal in the heavenlies to rain down blessing on our nation, because those who bless Israel will be blessed and those who curse her will be cursed. And on that note, that is why we are here, to raise money for Israel. And it is our privilege as Ruth Branch to raise money for Israel through WIZO. So I hope we make thousands of dollars, rands, through this concert tonight. And on that note, I want to actually share with you how this feast relates to the days of creation. And what did God do on the seventh day? He rested. And it wasn't because God needed a rest, we all know that. But we needed the rest, as you know. And all he wanted to do was be with his people one day a week, that we could down tools and just enjoy him and his creation. And then how does that relate to the seventh command, the commandments? The seventh commandment is, thou shalt not commit adultery. And to me, it is also spiritual adultery. It is time to abandon our foreign gods. Just like the story of Rahab. My goodness, there was a prostitute, Erez, without hope and without God. And she heard about this God of the Israelites that were heading for her city. And she was very clever. And she decided to align herself. She knew the spies would be coming. And she befriended them and made a deal, as you know the story. And she said, I'll help you if you help me and save my family. And you know the story about the red cord. And this is where, on a personal level, I think us Christians are wanting to align ourselves with the House of Israel and help you fulfill your destiny as a nation to eventually, with Mashiach, become a light to all the nations. This is Israel's destiny.
To wrap up then, the micro version of this blueprint, Erez, for life and happiness goes like this. Number one, Passover. We all are needing to come out of our Egypts, right? Number two, Shavuot. We all need to make a very important choice of what God we are serving. And hopefully it is the God of Israel, and to follow his ways and his commandments. Number three, if we do, Hashem will come and tabernacle with us. And when we trust in him, oh my goodness, in spite of this world and its chaos and hatred, he will push back the darkness.
So Howie, Saxton, Erez and I and the whole team want to thank you.
You're just amazing.
You're amazing.
Such phenomenal work.
That's right. Absolutely. And how you've blessed so many people, kept the Jewish community together. It's just phenomenal. So how we thank you, we salute you, my brother. And we also want to thank all those that were part of this concert and those that sponsored us, because as you are watching, it was for free. And without our sponsors, Erez and I wouldn't have done this. So thank you from the bottom of our hearts.
Well, I have a feeling that a lot of people at the end of the show will still put their name to paper and put down and commit to a few more shekels towards this, because now that they see what's going on, I'm sure they'll be ready to throw lots of money at you, so in it as well. What do
Please
you think?
God, from your mouth to his ears. So on that note, I just want to, while Erez gets up and goes and joins the band for the last finale, our wonderful, famous Leonard Cohen song called Hallelujah. And so enjoy it. And from me, I just want to say to everyone, Chag Sameach and Shalom.
Shalom. Thank you, Liz.
We've seen the sight, we've heard those tales, came so close our courage failed, but you beckoned us and told us to look to you. Those walls have stood, but they will fall, without a sword and without the shield. We'll simply stand and cry out, Hallelujah, 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 Hallelujah.
She promised them, she gave a word that they would be unseen and heard. The plan she made, she knew which way to view you. Our lives for yours, they swore in turn, as all around you falls and burns. Just close your door and whisper Hallelujah, 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 Hallelujah.
Save her now. The scarlet thread becomes a vow. She'll tie it round herself and look up to you. A break of bread in a wall of stone, a banner raised before your throne, a grateful voice that cries out, Hallelujah.
she promised not to turn away. She knew the pain, and still she stayed. The life before can't hold a candle to you. This bitterness, it will not last. Your bridges span across the pass, and soon we will return to hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Tonight is absolutely incredible, absolutely fantastic. I can feel it almost coming from you right there at home. Almost. Now I want to feel it completely, not just almost. So you guys are going to sing with us. We're going to play and you're going to sing. Here we go.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Beautiful.
Hallelujah.
עצרת בעלה גם בשמחה ובצהלה. תוך אמונה
at home didn't hear you perfectly. Will you tell him one more time? Here we go.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
And now that we're so excited, and we're so that was fantastic, wasn't that something? Now that we're so excited, we'd like to ask you people at home to remember, very, very importantly, this is a huge and incredible fundraiser for WIZO and for our beloved country, Israel. So I was going to say make a small donation, but forget about that. Make a huge donation. We'd like everybody at home to please remember what this is all about, what this is for, unity, togetherness, and helping to support Israel. So please help us. You'll have the details later. We'd like to see a wonderful donation from each and every person at home. Are we ready? Yes, we are. Thank you very much.
Well, the Sixth Woven Destiny concert has just ended. And we are about to continue celebrating in our Sukkah. Myself, Elizabeth, Jamie, the entire Woven Destinies team. We are so excited at this project and so excited at this concert. And my friends, this is the backstage pass that you've been waiting for. Aside, of course, from the very, very wonderful and warm feeling that via WIZO, we are helping those that, especially in our time of joy, need our support, need our love, need our care, and need our funding. They need our money, yes. So I'm going to ask you to pick up your phone right now. Yes, take it in your hand. Great. And take a photograph of this. Yeah. I'm waiting. Good. Now keep that photograph, because that photo has got all the information that you need, all the different ways that you're able to donate. As I say, especially in our time of joy, my friends, reach deep into our pockets and let's see what we can do to support those that are less privileged than we are right now in our beloved country, Israel. My friends, from me, from the team, from Elizabeth, from the entire Woven Destinies team, we look forward to another extravaganza, another project, another concert. We look forward to sharing our unity, sharing our joy, sharing our love, and sharing our care for our beloved country, Israel. From me to you, shalom, laila tov, todah, good night.